Proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Ladies and gentlemen, Pastor John P. Goodloe, Sr.
As is my tradition, I'm asking, please, that as I pray, that you would pray in the tradition that is yours. We live in such a wonderful country, a diverse place, and we celebrate that diversity. And even in our recognition of our God, we do the same. Shall we pray, please? Dear God, we're asking that you would bless us as we come to this place, recognizing, first of all, who you are. We thank you so much for the privilege that we have in this recognition, and we hallow your name. We're reminded, O God, of your letting us know through your Son how necessary it is for us to die to ourselves as you did in the Garden of Gethsemane, saying, not my will, but yours be done. We ask, Father, that you would help us in our dying to serve others. And it doesn't matter the nationality, the color of skin, nor does it matter the position or rank. Help us to serve. And what a great example we have of the Good Samaritan who saw one in need. And so we follow that example, O God, as we see others in need. Help us then to serve them, even at the expense of ourselves, even when we recognize that that might be taking something from us. Help us to serve. And so we recognize those who have done just that. And we ask, God, that you would bless them. And as you did many, many times over, not only do you bless them, but you, O Father, with those who serve and for those who serve, you give to them many times over. We again thank you for this place. We thank you for those in leadership. We thank you, O God, for those, O Father, who have made this time possible. And so, Lord, in this recognition of service, we honor you. For the supreme God, the sovereign God, you served us. And you gave of yourself for us and to us that we might have life. And at this time, we say thank you. We ask that these things be done, that with a heart of gratitude we might say thank you to those who have served. And in this, we pray, I pray in my tradition, in the name of Jesus. Let us all say amen.
Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ms. Jennifer C. Walsh, Performance Improvement Officer and Director of Administration and Management.
I want to be able to see you. Good morning, everyone, and welcome. What a great reason to get together on a Thursday morning. It's an honor for me to join you in celebrating the Department of Defense Public Service Recognition Week Spirit of Service Ceremony. During the first week in May, we take time away from our work in defense of our nation to acknowledge those members of the department who have demonstrated significant contributions in service to our country. As we commence this recognition of our award recipients this morning, it is very fitting that we begin with a word from our Deputy Secretary of Defense, the Honorable Kathleen Hicks. I'll ask you to turn your attention here. And hope you can read lips. I'll call an audible here and ask our team if we could see if perhaps later in the ceremony, if we were to replay that, if we could get it with the sound, because I know sometimes the distance, it was hard for me to read from a screen that far, but I know the deputy is a lifelong public servant herself, sends her best regards and her appreciation and also her recognition of the honorees today. So the deputy secretary mentioned a number of things in her message, and one of those focused on serving family and community and advancing the common good. These are tenets of public service. And today we're going to recognize members of the Department of Defense who are among the finest of our public servants. Their contributions in areas such as transforming healthcare delivery, driving innovation in digital interoperability, digital mission architecture, or advancing interoperability with allies and partners. All of these reinforce the department's priorities of taking care of people, defending our nation, and succeeding through teamwork. A theme consistent among all of these recipients today is that they not only lead in their areas of expertise, but they also share knowledge and mentor their teammates within their organizations and then across this institution. They guide their colleagues and teams and build resilience in the workforce. These dedicated civilian career employees have worked tirelessly on behalf of all Americans. They often work quietly behind the scenes and don't often receive the recognition we know they clearly deserve. As a department that serves the defense of our nation, we are grateful for the strength, the talent, and the dedication these men and women bring to the civilian career force every day. When we need you most, you're always ready to give. You work tirelessly and faithfully to serve the best interests of others. President Lyndon B. Johnson once said, "You will find meaning only by sharing in the responsibilities, the dangers, and the passions of your time." Those we honor this morning have demonstrated this so unmistakably, that public service is more than just doing their work in the department efficiently and honestly. It is a complete dedication to the good of all the American people we serve across and within our communities. This morning, we take this moment to recognize and express the department's appreciation for what you, these civilian members of our team of the department, do for the American people. So it's my honor now to move into the part of the program where we get to introduce these amazing colleagues and recognize them as Spirit of Service honorees.
Presenting the award on behalf of the Office of the Undersecretary of Defense for Research and Engineering is the Honorable Elmer L. Roman, Deputy Assistant Secretary of Defense for Mission Integration. The award recipient from the Office of the Undersecretary of Defense for Research and Engineering is Mr. Jaime J. Bestard, Chief Engineer, Office of the Assistant Secretary of Defense for Mission Capabilities. Presenting the award on behalf of the Defense Counterintelligence and Security Agency is Mr. Daniel J. Leese, Deputy Director of the Defense Counterintelligence and Security Agency. The award recipient from the Defense Counterintelligence and Security Agency is Mr. Salvatore J. DeMarco, Chief Engineer, Government Information Specialist, Congressional Liaison. Presenting the award on behalf of the Defense Contract Audit Agency is Ms. Terry L. Dilley, Director, Defense Contract Audit Agency. The award recipient from the Defense Contract Audit Agency is Ms. Alicia M. Freelon, Senior Auditor. Presenting the award on behalf of the Defense Health Agency is Mr. John Windham, Deputy Director, Federal Electronic Health Record Modernization. The award recipient from the Defense Health Agency is Mr. Charles Gabriel, Digital Health Standards Lead. Presenting the award on behalf of the Office of the Undersecretary of Defense for Personnel and Readiness is Ms. Ann Lee, Executive Director of the Office of the Undersecretary of Defense for Personnel and Readiness. The award recipient from the Office of the Undersecretary of Defense for Personnel and Readiness is Ms. Brianne M. Neesham, Attorney Advisor. Thank you. Presenting the award on behalf of the Defense Technical Information Center is Dr. April J. Erickson, Assistant Secretary of Defense for Science and Technology. The award recipient from the Office of the Undersecretary of Defense for Research and Engineering is Mr. Matthew W. Poe, Chief Data Officer, Defense Technical Information Center. Presenting the award on behalf of the White House Military Office is Ms. Ruth S. Vedder, DoD Deputy General Counsel for Personnel and Health Policy. The award recipient from the White House Military Office is Mr. Paul Turney, Deputy General Counsel. Presenting the award on behalf of the Office of Local Defense Community Cooperation is Mr. Patrick J. O'Brien, Director of the Office of Local Defense Community Cooperation, Office of the Undersecretary of Defense, Acquisition and Sustainment. The award recipient from the Office of Local Defense Community Cooperation is Mr. Michael A. Wilson, Deputy Director of Compliance. Presenting the award on behalf of the Department of the Army is Mr. Roy A. Wallace, Assistant Deputy Chief of Staff, G1. The award recipients from the Department of the Army are Mr. Vernon Baum, Chief Campaign Analysis Division, Center for Army Analysis, Office of the Deputy Chief of Staff, G8. Ms. Maritza Cordova Kennedy, Human Resources Specialist, Office of the Administrative Assistant to the Secretary of the Army. Mr. Jonathan J. Lee, Senior Enterprise Architecture, Office of the Deputy Chief of Staff, G1. Ms. Deborah M. Woods, Program Information System Security Manager, Office of the Deputy Chief of Staff, G1. Presenting the award on behalf of the Office of the Joint Staff is Mr. Matthew Stump, Vice Director for Joint Force Development and Design Integration, J7. The award recipient from the Office of the Joint Staff is Ms. Jessica R. Todd, Director, Future Technology Office, Joint Force Integration, Joint Force Development Directorate. Presenting the award on behalf of the Department of the Navy is Mr. Nicholas J. Deanna, performing the duties of Vice Director, Naval Staff Office of the Chief of Naval Operations. The award recipients from the Department of the Navy are Ms. Diane L. Del Coco, Event Specialist, Department of the Navy, Assistant for Administration. Mr. Richard O. McMillan, Supervisory Information Technology Specialist, Policy Planning Network, Deputy Chief of Naval Operations for Operations, Plans, and Strategy. Mr. Jeffrey J. Roman, International Program Policy Officer, Office of the Chief of Naval Operations. Ms. Holly S. Westmiller, Resources Requirements Assistant Program Manager, Surface Training Systems, Naval Sea Systems Command. Presenting the award on behalf of the United States Marine Corps is Lieutenant General Greg P. Olson, Director, Marine Corps Staff, Headquarters, United States Marine Corps. The award recipients from the United States Marine Corps are Mr. George E. Berger, Program Manager, Emergency Dispatch Services, Marine Corps Installations Command. Miss Angela D. Howard, Enterprise Program Manager, Defense Travel System, Programs and Resources Department, Headquarters Marine Corps. Presenting the award on behalf of the Department of the Air Force is the Honorable Alex Wagner, Assistant Secretary of the Air Force for Manpower and Reserve Affairs. The award recipients from the Department of the Air Force are Ms. Brandy A. Barrere, Program Protection Lead, System Security Engineering and Cyber Division, Office of the Deputy Assistant Secretary of the Air Force for Science, Technology, and Engineering.
Concocting the formula.
Mr. Robin L. Broderick, Chief, Medical Law Branch, Claims and Tort Litigation Division, Air Force Legal Operations Agency. Ms. Lori A. Murphy, Chief, Department of the Air Force Voluntary Education Programs and Air Force Automated Education Management System Program Manager, A1D, A1, Manpower, Personnel, and Services. Mr. Michael S. Nelson, Senior Facilities Sustainment, Restoration, and Modernization Policy Manager, Headquarters Air Force. Ms. Valerie N. Stengel, Chief of Staff, Plans and Programs, Headquarters, Air Force. Ladies and gentlemen, please turn your attention to the screens for words from the Honorable Kathleen Hicks, Deputy Secretary of Defense.
As we celebrate Public Service Recognition Week this year, it's my honor to celebrate all those who work in government and for the public good, including the civilians and military personnel.
First of all, I'm blessed to be sitting beside Mrs. Walsh, and she said rather generously, I could act it out. That's just wonderful. Congratulations to the recipients. God bless you. Let's pray. Oh, yes, why don't we? Shall we pray again in that tradition that is yours? Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is envy, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. We are so grateful for these recipients. But more than that, O God, we're so thankful for what they have done. For they gave of themselves, without seeking recognition necessarily, and yet we know how important it is to recognize those who have given of themselves. And so we thank you, first of all, for carving them out, for speaking into their lives and for making it so that they might have an opportunity to so serve. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and ever. Again in my tradition, in Jesus' name, let us all say amen. Amen. Go and do likewise. Thank you.
Congratulations to the Spirit of Service Award recipients. This concludes today's ceremony. Thank you for attending and enjoy the rest of your day.